Good morning, children. Today, let us start that exercise 1. The exercise 1 is based on BPT and converse of BPT. First problem, in figure, DE is parallel to BC. We have to find out EC. AD, DB and AE are given. We have to find out EC. So, in triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC, so we can apply the BPT. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC, therefore AD by DB is equal to AE by EC by BPT. So now substitute for AD. AD is equal to 1.5 cm, DB is equal to 3 cm and AE is 1. EC we have to find out. Take the cross multiplication. EC is equal to 3 by 1.5. So 1.5 ones are 2s are. So EC is equal to 2 cm. Next problem. In figure, find the values of x if DE is parallel to AB. So in the triangle CAB, DE is parallel to AB, CD, DA, CE and EB are given. We have to find out the value of x. So in triangle CAB, DE parallel to AB. So therefore, CD by DA is equal to CE by EB. CE by EB by BPT. Now substitute CD is equal to 4 cm and DA is x minus 4 and CE is x minus 3 and EB is 3x minus 19. Next, take the cross multiplication. 4 into 3x minus 19 is equal to x minus 3 into x minus 4. 4 3s are 12x. 4 19s are 76 is equal to x square minus 3x minus 4x is minus 7x plus 12. Next, take 12x minus 76 to RHS. X square minus 7x plus 12 minus 12x plus 76 is equal to 0. X square minus 7x minus 12x is minus 19x plus 12 plus 76 is plus 88 is equal to 0. Now you got the equation x square minus 19x plus 88 is equal to 0. Factorize the equation. The product should be 88 and the sum should be 19. So 11 8s are 88. 11 plus 8 is 19. The middle term carries minus. So put minus for both the factors. Now the factors of x square minus 19x plus 88 are x minus 11 into x minus 8 is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 11 or x is equal to 8. So, the values of x are 8 and 11. Next problem. In figure, DE is parallel to AC and DF is parallel to AE, prove that BF by EF is equal to BE by CE. Say the triangle ABC. Here, DE is parallel to AC. So, by BPT, we can write BD by DA is equal to BE by CE. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to AC. So, we can write BD by DA is equal to BE by CE by BPT. Consider this as equation 1. Now consider the triangle ABE. Here DF is parallel to AE, Therefore, BD by DA is equal to BF by EF. Consider this as equation 2. From 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, we get. So, in equation 1, we have BD by DA is equal to BA by CA. In equation 2, we have BD by DA is equal to BF by EF. So, from 1 and 2, we get BA by CA is equal to BF by EF. BE by CE is equal to BF by EF. Next problem. In figure, DE is parallel to OQ and DF is parallel to OR. Show that EF is parallel to QR. Now say the triangle POQ. Here DE is parallel to OQ. DE is parallel to OQ means we can write PE by EQ is equal to PD by DO by BPT. Consider this as equation 1. Next, in triangle POR, DF is parallel to OR. So, we can write PD by DO is equal to PF by FR. Consider this as equation 2. In equation 1, we have PE by EQ is equal to PD by DO. In equation 2, we have PF by FR is equal to PD by DO. Here, RHS are same. So, we can equate the LHS. From 1 and 2, we get PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. So, PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. It means EF divides the line PQ and PR in equal ratio. You know, if a line divides the two sides of a triangle in equal ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side by converse of BPT. Therefore, EF is parallel to QR. Next question. In the given figure, AB parallel to DE and BD parallel to EF, prove that DC square is equal to CF into AC. Now, consider the triangle ABC. Here, AB is parallel to DE, so we can write AC by DC is equal to BC by EC by corollary of BPT. So, consider this as equation 1. Now, consider the triangle CDB. Here, BD is parallel to EF. So, we can write DC by CF is equal to BC by EC by corollary of BPT. Consider this as equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, we get AC by DC is equal to DC by CF. Now, take the cross multiplication. DC into DC is DC square is equal to CF into AC. Next question. ABCD is a trapezium with AB parallel to DC. E and F are points on non-parallel sides AD and BC respectively such that EF is parallel to AB. Show that AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. Now, write the given. Here, ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC and E and F are the points on the non-parallel side AD and BC such that EF is parallel to AB. We have to prove AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. Now, join AC such that it intersect EF at G. Now, in triangle ADC, EG is parallel to DC. Therefore, AE by ED is equal to AG by GC by BPT. Consider this as equation 1. Now, in triangle ABC, GF is parallel to AB. Therefore, BF by FC is equal to AG by GC by PPT. Consider this as equation 2. So, from equation 1 and 2, we get AE by ED is equal to BF by FC. Next problem, ABCD is a trapezium in which AB parallel to DC and its diagonals intersect each other at O. Show that AO by OC is equal to BO by DO. Or prove that the diagonals of a trapezium divide each other proportionally. Now write the given. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC and the diagonals AC and the BD intersect at the point O. We have to prove AO by OC is equal to BO by DO. Now, through the point O, draw EO parallel to AB intersecting AD at E. In triangle ACD, EO is parallel to DC, therefore AE by ED is equal to AO by OC. By BPT, we can consider this as equation 1. Now, in triangle ABD, EO is parallel to AB, so we can write AE by ED is equal to BO by OD. Consider this as equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, we get AO by OC is equal to BO by OD. It means the diagonals of a trapezium divide each other proportionally. Next question. The diagonals of a quadrilateral ABCD intersect each other at O such that AO by OC is equal to BO by OD. Show that ABCD is a trapezium. Now, write the given. ABCD is a quadrilateral in which the diagonals AC and BD intersect at the point O such that AO by OC is equal to BO by OD. Now, we have to prove ABCD is a trapezium. Now, draw EO parallel to DC intersecting AD at the point E. Now, in triangle ACD, EO is parallel to DC, so we can write AO by OC is equal to AE by ED. Consider this as equation 1. But in the question, AO by OC is equal to BO by OD. It is given in the question. Consider this as equation 2. So from 1 and 2, we get AE by ED is equal to BO by OD. So, AE by ED is equal to BO by OD. It means the line AEO divides the side AD and BD in equal ratio. You know, if a line divides the two sides of a triangle in equal ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side by converse of BPT. So, EO is parallel to AB. But EO is parallel to DC by construction. Therefore, if EO is parallel to AB and EO is parallel to DC, therefore we can write AB is parallel to DC. If AB is parallel to DC, then the quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. Since the opposite sides of the quadrilateral are parallel, therefore, the quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. Next question. If three or more parallel lines are intersected by two transversal, prove that the intercepts made by them on the transversal are proportional. Now see the figure. Here the line LMN are parallel to each other and the transversal LM and PQ intersect the line LMN at A, C, E and B, D and F respectively. Here AC and CE are the intercepts made by the transversal LF and BD and DF are the intercepts made by the transversal PQ. So we have to prove the intercepts made by the transversal are proportional. It means we have to prove AC by CE is equal to BD by DF. Now join EF which intersect the CD at the point O. Now join AF which intersects CD at O. Now consider the triangle AEF. In triangle AEF, CO is parallel to AF. Therefore, we can write AC by CE is equal to AO by OF. Consider this as equation 1. Now consider the triangle ABF. Here OD is parallel to AB. So we can write BD by DF is equal to AO by OF. Consider this as equation 2. Now see the equation on 1 and 2. Here the RHS are same, so we can equate the LHS. So from 1 and 2 we get AC by CE is equal to BD by DF. It means when three or more parallel lines are intersected by the two transversal, then the intercepts made by them are proportional. Next problem. In figure, if AD by DC is equal to BE by EC and angle CDE is equal to angle CED, prove that triangle CAB is isosceles triangle. In triangle ABC, AD by DC is equal to BE by CE. It is given, you know, when a line divides the two sides of a triangle in equal ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side by a converse of BPT. Therefore, DE is parallel to AB. When DE is parallel to AB, angle CDE and angle A are the corresponding angles and angle CED and angle B are the corresponding angles. Since DE is parallel to AB, angle CDE is equal to angle A and angle CED is equal to angle B. But angle CDE is equal to angle CED given. So since angle CDE is equal to angle CED, therefore angle A is equal to angle B. Angle A is equal to angle B. So here in the triangle ABC, angle A is equal to B. Angle A is equal to B means if the two angles of a triangle are equal, then the side opposite to the equal angles are also equal. So we can write the side opposite to the angle A is BC and the side opposite to the angle B is AC. Therefore, AC is equal to BC. Since the two sides of the triangle ABC are equal, then the triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle.